Hi friends, welcome to the third part of the video collecting soft copy of written assignment from students. The thing which we are validating the assignment by teacher. If you are unaware of how to create the assignment from teacher's end and if you have missed the part 1 video, you can just locate it in the info corner, or else you can just go and browse my channel for that video. And here I am in the teacher's ID. And I'm getting inside my class, and this is the assignment I've given. Okay, let me just move on to the instructions column, and I'll give a quick recap of what has been given to the student. So I'm asking the students to submit a handwritten copy of their following question. Okay, I've given a question for them, and what should be there in that question, I've given the instruction. And the student, they are going to write their assignment in a sheet, and they'll take a snapshot of the written copy, and they'll upload it. Okay, they have uploaded it, right? Now let us move on to the student's work corner. Here you could see two things, turned in and another one is assigned. Okay, two type of people are there in this particular area. Turned in means those who have submitted the assignment. Okay, if for example here my class is having only one student, and he has submitted the assignment. Okay, if there are any persons, okay, if there is a number here in the assigned column, that means the persons, number of persons who have not yet submitted the assignment. Okay, so that's what the meaning of assigned, right? So my only one student of my class have submitted the assignment. Now I want to validate it. Okay, so just select the student, and you could see the space for marking the grade and the attachment the student has given us. Okay, so I'm going to just click on the attachment. Yes, here it is, right? Whatever assignment he has submitted me, it is available here. Okay, and we are about to return the assignment to the student, right? After putting grade, we'll be returning it to the student, so he can see why we have given mark and why we have denied some marks. Okay, so you can choose any color of your choice, and you can mark things. Okay, so this is right, this is right, and this is right, and this is right, and yeah, that's it, everything is right. If you want something to get marked, means you can just mark it, right? That you can do. Okay, so I validated it and everything is right. Okay, so I'm going to save this one. Okay, the document is getting saved now. Yes, now you could see two attachments here in this attachment column. One is the original image which is sent by, this one is the original assignment sent by the student, and the second one which we have edited, in the sense we have just corrected and marked certain things, right? So which one is right or wrong, if you want to have any sort of annotation to be done, you can do it. Okay, so such file is available on the second part. Okay, right, and I'm going to place the grade now. For this assignment I'm going to give 10 marks. Okay, so I'm not going to reduce any marks for him, so I can just add a private comment for him: avoid striking out things in the page. So this is a private comment I want to make it to the student. Okay, this will only appear for that guy alone. Okay, right, so here is the written option. You can find a button on the top called written, right? And if you press this button, his grade will be sent, and also he can see what comment you have made it over in this edited image, and you can send this comment. Okay, I'm sending this comment now. So I have made a private comment, and then I am pressing return button. Okay, return, that's it, work return to the original author. Okay, fine. So now you could see three options here: the remaining turned in assignments are 0, and unsubmitted assignments are 0. One assignment has been submitted and it has been graded. Okay, you have given the grade for the student here. Okay, fine. So this is how you will grade your student. Okay, if you want to see the view of a student, okay, I'm switching the accounts now to the student ID. So this is where the student is working. So let me go and see the assignment status now. Yeah, in my work section I could see my percentage, right? My grade, my teacher just gave me 10 out of 10, and I could see the edited image, right? So I can open it up and see what he has done for me. So first one is right, second one is right. Yes, that's it. Okay, so my original image and whatever the teacher has marked, right? So that image also I got. So this is how you will create or you will validate a student's assignment. If you have any queries, you can just post it on the comment section or you may directly call me. Thank you so much.